You're asking which one?
But I got married. What's your problem? God's way to success. I would like you to comment and answer, as you answer, is there God's way? Does work, hard work for that matter, form part of that way?
I've come upon young people who believe that hard work kills. And they don't want to be the first. So they avoid it at all costs. There are two words which come to my mind when I think about God's way to success. One is plan, and the other is surrender. And it looks like there's a contradiction. Plan and surrender. When I graduated, or just the week before I graduated from Nairobi University, I went by the CCU. Those of you who know Nairobi University, the Central Catering Unit, on the left of that unit, or the right, whichever way you look at it, there's a swimming pool, and beyond there, there was a big field. I think that is a graduation square. And I sat on one of those platforms there and planned my next 10 years. I planned and I wrote all the things, and there were about 10 things which I wanted to achieve in the next 10 years of my life after university. What do you think item number one was? For sure, you are prophet. There she is. So I purposely planned what I would do, including building my own house in the city, and I didn't have land. I didn't inherit any, but I plan to do that in the next 10 years. And you know what? Within the next 10 years, I had achieved most of those things. Actually, 99%, except one, which I'm still working on right now.
You're asking which one?
But I got married. What's your problem? That one is off.
What am I saying? You need to plan. Our God is a God of order. He is not obligated, and his testimony is about that. He's not obligated to give you what you write, what you plan. He can change, he can adjust, he can take you away from singing to other unrelated things. He can do that, and he does that all the time. But let me tell you, our God is a God of order. Plan your life. And plan the things you want to trust God for. Project them. Tell God, this one is what I want. And then delight yourself in him. He says what? He will give you the desires of your heart. Number two, the second one is surrender. Give yourself fully to God. So there's no contradiction. You plan because he has given us a mind, and he wants us to plan. He has given us the intellect, the ability to think and to organize and to do things. Don't be a disorganized person. And you know, looking at you, I think you have great opportunities to plan your life, but also surrender that to God and say, your will be done. And then he will give you what he wants you to give you, what he wants to give you. Now, hard work. In this country, we are living a lie. And please don't buy it. If you're going to have an impact in this society, which is in desperate need of a positive impact, you've got to work hard. There's no shortcut to hard work. Whether where you are is by design or by default, humanly speaking, God got you there. But you've got to work. You've got to rise from the television, watching television, to work, and work very hard. Hard work does not kill. I know you are looking at me thinking I'm wrong. I'm actually right.
I agree with you.
Hard work does not kill. And God worked. Be
like your father's son or daughter. For 7 days he created the world and all that is in there. And then he created man and woman. And he is inviting us to work, to multiply, to prosper as we work very hard.
Just to
in this tree, I was saying there is a lie that you can't get rich overnight. Indeed, you can, but it will be the wrong way of getting money. And it will not satisfy. That is the point we are putting through. If you steal, I hear now the most popular courses are on procurement, because you want to go and work in the county government and steal through that, but we will catch up with you. You see what's going on. We will catch up with you. And even if we don't, God will not bless you if you are stealing. Work hard. God work. Good work.
The Fellowship of Christian Unions, reaching students, changing nations.